I would like to call upon Professor K.K. Vellore, Director in Charge BIMM, to welcome our guest with a bouquet.
Thank you, sir. May we now call upon Shreyansh Pradhan, Student Manager, Balaji Institute of Telecom and Management, to introduce sir.
A very good afternoon to one and all present here. It's my proud privilege to introduce our guest speaker for this session, Mr. Sumit Rajwade. Sumit sir has 17 years of experience in building large-scale data systems, PC and mobile-based thin and think product development, CRM systems, and building technology infrastructure. He is an expert in platform development and technology management. Sumit sir is currently Vice President Technology at Rediff.com India Limited. Sir started his professional career with TCS and is alumni of VJTI Mumbai and Parle College, Mumbai. Sir has been awarded CIO Choice Award thrice in a row. Sir, the podium is all yours.
There's no clip, is it?
Hello? You can hear me? By the time he's setting, twist, turn, stretch, take a minute's break. Yep. You can dim these lights. You don't need these lights. Okay, good afternoon. Who's catching Pokemon right now? No one? Okay, good. So, I think I have little less time, and I know this is the discussion about how does one develop a skill as opposed to knowledge or expertise to face the career when you go in. I'll only share my experiences in next 10 to 12 slides, and that won't last more than 30 minutes, so won't encroach too much on your tea break, a lot awaited tea break. And what I'll do is, I'll tell you why it is important to have one aspect, since you are the students of telecom management. I call it a logical mind. Why you have to develop a skill called as a logical mind to go forward in any industry you are. You can be in marketing, you can be in IT services, you can join team building in companies, but you'll have to have a logical mind. And the discussion about today's topic is how does one build a logical mind on top of this current generation's revolution, which is called as information. Okay? You know, we've been through textile revolution when the spinning jenny came, all the textiles started happening. During World War II, the revolution changed from textile to chemical industry revolution. So bombs were made and the chemicals dominated the entire game. Now we have something called as the information revolution. If you lose a phone today, you won't feel as bad about the device being lost, but the data on the device being lost. Right? How many of you take the backup of your phones? Impossible. Oh, very good. I'm impressed. So, let's go back to our slides and let's start. What I'll do is I'll break this entire discussion into three parts. Should we take 30 seconds break? More twisting? Okay, continue. The first part, I'll talk about setting up the right background, why the logical mind plays a role in today's generation, why it is important for you to build a career. The second part, we'll talk about specific to Indian scenarios, what are the skills you have to sharpen. And the third one is three methods of looking at information. If you imbibe in your skill set, you will be able to logically tackle the problems that you will face on an ongoing basis. So what is this? This is a horseless carriage. During the wars, people used to use the best of the horses. As the horses used to get old or tired, they used to be moved into pulling the chariots like this. So these horseless carriages were initially used with the horse, where people will use this for travel. During 1875, somebody built an engine where instead of a horse, you can use an engine to run the wheels. See the report, what it was presented by the committee who evaluated this engine. A new source of power called gasoline has been produced by Boston engineers. Instead of burning the fuel under a boiler, it is exploded inside a cylinder of an engine. They called it a motor engine. The dangers are obvious. Stores of gasoline in the hands of people interested primarily in profits would constitute a fire and explosive hazard of the first rank. 1875. People who were the advocates of horses and carriages that were pulled with horses. Imagine today's world without engines. No boats, no airlines, no cars. You are in the same situation today. Instead of bursting gasoline in engines, people are trying to burst the volumes of data by processing them in a logical way and building business out of it. How? Let's look at some snippets that matter. Let's move to Indian scenario. Thanks to Jio, this number will rise, but as of today, there are 100 million active broadband users and 3G users in the country. Right or wrong? Very good. Are you all broadband users?
Yes, sir.
I'll tell you why you are privileged in the next slide. Otherwise, the internet beyond 8 metro cities is very spotty and it's not working well. Second snippet. At 90 million, we are a billion population country. At 90 billion, we will exhaust our audience who speaks English. What do? You are supposed to manage building of the products and building of the skills that are repurposed for audience to consume, and at 90 million, English speaking capacity is over. People will only know 200 words of English and Roman numerals. That's it. What do? There are 200 million people who recognize 200 words in English. Who are those people? These are the people who are taxi drivers in Uber. These are the people who deliver your food parcels from Swiggy. They are not English-speaking people, but they use mobile phones. How? Average person in metro city, including Pune, uses 280 plus human-based services in his life. Agreed? Imagine yourself staying at home. Newspaper delivery guy, milk delivery guy, grocery delivery guy, clothes ironing delivery guy. You are surrounded by 280 plus human-based services. And you are supposed to repurpose products which are of their use so that they can serve you. The future of what you build as a skill lies in you building products and services, being savvy users for those who are not savvy. You've traveled by Uber and Ola? Do you know the person who's sitting on the driver's seat can barely speak English? What is he taught? He's taught 5 commands. When you'll receive a call, say accept and call the person in case you don't know how to find a direction. When you start, when the person boards, hit the button called as start. Keep driving, you will see the navigation, how to go turn left and right. Once you reach the destination, press the button stop. Whatever amount is displayed on the screen is the money that you should collect from the person. If it is 0, say thank you, have a nice day and depart. Minimum English knowledge being served to 200 million people so that they can serve 90 million people like you. This is today. This is real Indian scenario. Now imagine keeping this in mind. What kind of skills should you develop so that you can build better products and services? This is a Goldman Sachs chart. Goldman Sachs in our industry is known as a priest who confirms a marriage. There's a priest that you need to confirm a marriage, right? Saying you are now, I declare you as husband and wife. Goldman Sachs reports endorses the scenario of what the audience in India is today. People take this as a statement of belief and do investments going forward. This particular chart, where's the pointer here? Is this? Oh, this one? Okay, thanks. This particular chart is called as an educated urban mass. You all belong in this category. There are only 32 million such people in this country. Most of the people who are serving you are people who are urban blue-collar migrant workers who've come to metro to earn their living. And there are 97 million people here. And there are people who are 120 million who are waiting to step up the ladder so that they can come and enter this bandwagon called as digital medium. And nobody will be staying away from it. I was talking to one of your college members and he asked me, what do you think is the news reading habit of users? I said, I do not believe students or youngsters like you read news. You might be reading it out of no choice, but given a choice, you would prefer to read a news which is a video or a picture with 50 words which carries the story to you. And the famous avatar of news for your generation, if dog bites the man, it's not the news. If man bites the dog, it's the news. Correct. So unthinkable is the paradigm of the news. Moving ahead. There are 3 categories of people you'll always meet in whatever you do, in whichever products building you are, in whatever skill you deploy, in whatever angle of work will you do. Your logical mind should be able to split these people into 3 buckets. The top bucket are the people who do things for entertainment and fun. Most of you, being the telecom management people, might enter telecom or telecom associated industries. You'll deal with a lot of data, you'll deal with a lot of apps, you'll deal with a lot of information, behavioral science, you'll deal with a lot of metrics by which people will ask you, what can I do so that a person who's my user spends 1 more rupee with me? Or what can I do where 1 more user joins my consumer company? The top people are heavy people. They are experienced broadband users and they'll only do things for fun. They are the people who like flaunting the new gadgets, new mobile covers. They are the first one to adopt the new applications which are in your fancy. The middle one are the people who are most stingy and money-minded people. In a good way, not in a bad way. They will really look at discount schemes. And their claim to fame is something I have bought for 50 rupees. The guy will laugh at me and say, I bought it for 35 rupees. I'm smarter than you. The last long tail is where your real skill will play a role. And this is long tail. Let's take an example of what is real long tail. All of you have eaten in McDonald's. In how many ways you can order a burger? Suppose you take your closest friend and tell that friend, go and get me a Mac burger. The instruction is very straightforward. What burger you want? At best with or without cheese. From Mac, let's move to Subway. You know in how many ways a 6-inch subway can be made? 20,000? 8 breads, 12 varieties of filling, cheese, no cheese, toasted, not toasted, 8 fillings, 6 sauces, right? Your friend will never get what you want unless you instruct him well. And it is not true that next day you will eat the same thing that you ate the previous day. You are entering a genre where personalization of information and services is reaching its hilt, which in turn means people will need more choices. And how can you offer them more choices? You can't offer them by creating more choices. The only way you can offer them is by managing their expectations in a finite way. So 20,000 choices can be managed in 50 finite ways, which can satisfy 90% of the users, should be your goal to look at logical mind. Am I going too fast? Long tail is becoming more important. What is a long tail? It's not a tail of an animal. Long tail is, if there are 500 students who are sitting here and somebody asks them, what is a particular product that you would like to buy? They're giving 400 varieties of products for the simple reason because they are exposed to 400 varieties of products generates a long tail. Earlier, when even I was a student, I had only 3 streams to opt for: science, commerce, arts. Otherwise, sit at home. I did not know the 4th career line. When I post-graduated from VJTI, I just had 2 choices. There was no business line choice. Today, a friend of mine who's left the IT services company and did a 1-year course from UK is a dog psychiatrist. I'm not joking, it's a real long tail profession. There are dogs who only obey the masters, and somebody comes home, they bite the guest. So such dogs need dog psychiatrists. When I probed him a bit, he told me, it's not the dog I treat, it's the owners of the dog I treat. Because I tell them how to stay away from the dog, so dog doesn't bite the guests. Long tail has become very, very important as the time has elapsed. And the reason why it is more important is because you are exposed to more choices. How many products do you see on Amazon today? Millions. How many mobile cover varieties, 500 of you will have? More than 400? Hardly anyone will have a cover exactly same as somebody else. The reason why this is happening is because you have something which you have explored looking at the variety of products in front of you. You have made your choices, and those choices have to be made clear to you being managers now and serving these consumers. It's not easy. It is not easy to serve the people who have those kind of variety of choices. So how will you develop these mindsets going forward? Okay, let's come, since you are from telecom background, let's come to one slide which is called as the consumer and supplier side. There are 2 skills that are needed to deliver a promise. The top skill is called as an assurance. I'll give you an example of Uber. What is the assurance Uber gave? From the time you click on I need a cab, in US at least, a cab is available in 3 minutes and 17 seconds. Fair enough? What is the 80% intelligence they brought to the table? They told a driver where to stand exactly so that he can get the next person who will take the ride in 3 minutes and 17 seconds. Now, if you look at this, look at the 4 use cases. World's largest taxi service does not own a single cab. Uber doesn't own a single cab. They just have a mechanism by which they make the demand meet the supply. World's largest retailer, Amazon, does not hold a single inventory of any product. Correct? World's biggest media bank, Facebook, does not own any content. Neither they create any. And world's biggest accommodation finder, Airbnb, does not own a single room. Now you are talking about creating an ecosystem for yourself without owning the products and services. So what will come handy according to you in this case? The only thing that will come handy for you is how do you decode the data which is in front of you to make sure that people get what they want. The highest example is largest index in the world, Google, doesn't own a single web page. It has only indexed the web pages. It doesn't own anything. Moving ahead, let's move to the, after you've seen what the groundwork is, I'll talk about only three principles what will shape your logical mind in whatever careers you enter. You will not escape data, I can reasonably guarantee you that. Any career aspect you will enter, you will never ever be able to escape data and data analysis. Marketing people are doing data analysis. HR people are doing data analysis in terms of what kind of qualities I should look for in people so that I can hire better candidates. Technology people are doing data analysis so that how they can write more efficient code. First principle is data is very sparse. There is to no dearth or no extent, the data is getting expanded day by day. And it is only you who will be able to figure out, if you have that logical mind bend, how to look at data in subtle way so that you can make sense out of this data. Earlier, these things were not heard of. People used to just take and had a finite principles that they'll apply on anything they do. It doesn't work anymore. The second experiment is called as fraud detection. Have you heard of a case of the attempts that happened to withdraw money from ATM? A few cases you must have heard. You know what a logical skill means? You don't have to look at what is a fraudulent thing in these cases. The second aspect that you'll have to learn is which 95% data you should eliminate and ignore so you can focus on 5% data. I'll give you an example because I worked on this project. There is a CCTV camera which is installed in all ATM machines so that they can track the movements. Now, at least a few hundred people every day will walk in the ATMs, withdraw money and go. It's a normal logical pattern. What if somebody spends more than 1 minute in the ATM? Or what if instead of one people walking into ATM, two or three people walking into ATM next to the box at the same time? This is what is called as a fraud detection. So to detect a fraud, one has to understand how to eliminate the 95% good data and focus only on that 5% which matters the most. Are you confused or should I explain it? Sorry? See, I'll just explain it one more time because it is important if you do not exercise what is data all about, you will really, really not be able to make the best career out of what you are doing. You will face data challenges when you go in the career, in your early days as well. The first theory that I spoke about is it's not very easy for you to find out the patterns in a data. The second theory is if you are trying to detect something which is wrong, your mind should tell you what is a good thing to be eliminated first. And the third thing is at any given point, you should be able to group the data together. If you are not able to group the data together, or if you are not able to assimilate the data in a way by which you can present it, that these are the 20 ways by which I can serve these 1 million people who are telecom users so that they can opt in for pack A to Z and make it work, it will not happen. I'll give you an example of how Reliance came up with the new data packs. You know, they have named the packs small, medium, large, XL. They have given it the nomenclature of shirt sizes. Why do you think they have done this? For whom? Which consumers? No, they have made it easier for those consumers who do not understand English or what is the meaning of a data pack. These are those 200 million consumers I talked about who have basic knowledge of English, For them, when they clustered and analyzed the entire data of how their telecom services are being used by other Reliance company, they realized people do not understand what is a small pack or what is a big pack. You know, they also created a mini pack of 0.1 or 0.18 GB for 10 days. Yeah, a very small pack for a small amount. It is for those who are either traveling or who cannot afford a big data pack. So as you enter your careers, the first thing people will give you on month 2, an assignment will be given to you. Here's the data, help me analyze the data. And make a sense out of it. That will be your first roadblock on any aspect of career building. If you do not shape yourself into understanding the data the way it has to be analyzed and presented, you will completely miss out on what is happening as a revolution right now. So I'm only available, it's an orthogonal talk for your HR summit right now. I'm only appealing to one aspect which you have in you. It just needs a little bit of a polish. If you have time and energy to do it right now. And that skill is develop your logical mind. How to look at big data. If you can, you will be able to really make the right career out of it. And finally, to make the right sense out of large data, you just have to turn yourself 90 degrees. And what you can see is a face that makes sense. You got it? So, while at the end of the presentation, I just want to leave you with three thoughts from the skill development perspective. Ask yourself, how much have you been exposed to real data challenges? Have you really seen a big, good data? If no, try and download some data or create some data or get some data from your own professors, ask them, and try and spend some time how a data has to be looked upon. Point number two is basic statistical methods, very, very basic statistical methods, such as how do you data grouping, or how do you do data cleaning, or how do you do data elimination, how to use basic Excel pivots, have to be known to each one of you without a doubt. If you don't do it, the new wave of what telecom is about to explode with, which is apps and data, you will really miss out on it. And third, you are trying to build it for India. So imported stuff won't always work. You have to apply your own mind how a particular problem has to be solved for this country. So if you are observant, if you have a pain which belongs to you, that pain is actually something that you've felt, and if you are able to solve it for yourself, I'm almost certain you can solve it for everybody. Clear? So all I'm trying to tell you is, while most of the other speakers must have told you about leadership, about being different, about executing, about giving that extra 1%, I'm just asking you, be the student of science or maths. They have all blended together now. Have your conversation open with what you use as a data analytics software. You can use R, which is a free software, or you can use SPSS. At least, if nothing else, you can use Excel. Analyze this data, understand how a data shapes up, and try and solve problems only by applying your logical mind. I'm almost certain you will hit the success, or at least address some of the pain points of the companies that you will join and that the company will put in front of you by doing these things. Otherwise, I thank all of you for patience. It might sound not so right for you right now, but trust me, if you want to trust me on one thing, if you do not give importance to data, you will really miss out on something which is big. Try and give utmost importance that you can in your free life, so that you can become data savvy when you enter the careers. Yeah, I wish you all the best. Thank you.
Now the house is open for questions.
You have 5 minutes, right? There may be none. Was it a bouncer? Sure.
My question is related to the marketing concept. As we know, consumers are not rational buyers. Their buying decisions are based on individualistic perceptions about the product. So what are the uses of developing a logical mind as a marketing manager?
I'll tell you what logical mind means. You are not going to solve the consumer's problem. You know what is a gamification? It's a nice, interesting topic I can touch upon in literally 30 seconds. Gamification is not about solving somebody's problem. Gamification is about managing somebody's expectations. And you can only manage the expectations if you are able to know these are the four finite options. If I serve, chances of he liking it is 90%. So don't try and solve anybody's problem. Trust me, you can't. There are very rare instances where people can solve somebody's problems. You can only manage his expectations. My expectation is, the moment I place an order, the doorbell should ring. But the way online commerce companies manage this expectation is saying it will take 24 hours for you to ship. The moment the product is shipped, I get an SMS saying your product is on the way. And here's a tracking number, you can keep tracking it. Now if it takes 3 days, I am still fine because I am able to track it. But if it goes beyond 7 days, I might get irritated. So managing expectation is answer for solving consumer problems. It's not solving his problems.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
He asked me about the softwares that we need or the kind of storage that we need to process large data. That's okay, you can leave out the aberrations. See, I'll tell you, don't worry about those aspects right now. To answer your first half of the question, since you are all students, you will get access to Amazon with storage for free. You are aware of that? You all have free access. So you have free access to compute, you have free access to storage. Are you aware there is a software called as R, which is freely available? So you know there is a site called as data.gov.in, where all the data is freely available, including all the consumer data, all the behavioral data. So you have everything free. It is just your mind and initiative to form a group and launch it. Okay? And securities and these things will keep coming. I think there are others who solve it. Your job is to solve consumers' expectation management problem. Okay? We are done? Yep. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Today, we learn how to develop skills and knowledge for a logical mind and what is it important to have a logical mind. We also learn what is Indian scenario of logical mind. Sir, we look forward to many more such interactions on and off the campus.
Thank you, sir. May I now request Professor D.S. Kadam, Director of Projects and Alumni Affairs, Sri Balaji Society, to present a memento to Mr. Sumit Rajwade. May we now request one and all present to reassemble here at
Hello.